Assalamu alaikum everyone. My name is Gulay Zahra, here to bring a newspaper breakdown session courtesy of the KIPSI Assist Network. I hope that this video reaches you in good health and spirits. On May 28, 2020, Benjamin Netanyahu threatened to annex the remaining parts of the West Bank. This was met with a lot of outrage and uproar from the Palestinian side. And this annexation is going to be carried out according to the land demarcation plan that was laid out by Jared Kushner, who is the son-in-law of US President Donald J. Trump. This so-called Trump plan for the solution to the Palestinian and Israeli peace process, or a solution to the long standoff between Israel and Palestine, has been met by resistance by a lot of Palestinians, but a lot of Middle Eastern countries like Egypt and some Emirati countries as well, they believe that this is the only plan that can be implemented to a lasting solution for the Palestinian problem. But these plans have been halted in part because of the coronavirus pandemic and in part because of the internal strife that Israel is seeing and facing right now. America leads the world in the highest number of coronavirus cases per capita, and as of right now, Israel has surpassed that. Israel has more number of infectious cases per capita as compared to that of the US. So that is self-evident that the response towards the coronavirus pandemic, even a country like Israel that has access to any number of sophisticated healthcare systems, any number of healthcare professionals, they have managed to bungle up the response, and the Israelis are not happy. Not only that, Benjamin Netanyahu also faces a huge corruption case. And that is also being carried out, that has also been protested all across Israel as well. Now, state media, Israel's state media, is not reporting these protests. But the coverage from certain private Middle Eastern channels has put forward into glaring light the discrepancy between what the state, Israeli state, says and what its people want. The people in Israel, most of them, do not want Israel to annex any part of the West Bank, number one. Number two, they do not want Israel to carry out any of its more illegal activities concerning Palestine. And number three, they want Benjamin Netanyahu to step down in face of the coronavirus pandemic response and his corruption cases. So, what is the relevance for this entire chaos for Palestine? Ek baat bahut sochne wali hai ke अगर ऑब्जेक्टिवली इसको देखा जाए तो पैलेस्टीन कैन नॉट एग्जिस्ट ऑन इट्स ओन राइट नाउ. इट हैज़ बीन इकोनॉमिकली डेसिमेटेड, इट हैज़ बीन डेसिमेटेड लैंड वाइज, इट हैज़ बीन डेसिमेटेड ऑन एन इंटरनेशनल प्लेटफॉर्म इन सच अ मैनर दैट वी डू नॉट हैव एनी इंटर दे डू नॉट हैव एनी इंटरनेशनल प्लेटफॉर्म ऑन विच दे कैन से और स्पीक देयर वॉइसेस. Randa Al-Fateh, she is an Australian journalist. She has recently published an article where she says that any mention of Palestine, she resides in Australia, by the way, she has called out Australian authorities in trying to whitewash or in trying to erase any mention of Palestine from mainstream media channels or from newspapers. So you see, there is this concentrated effort to make sure that the Palestinians do not have a voice on an international scale, supported by the kind of people that have a lot of clout and a lot of money and a lot of power. So yahan kya tarike kar aur reh jata hai Palestinians ke paas? The only way that they have to move forward and have some kind of voice is to make sure that they somehow assimilate themselves within Israel. Theek hai? That is the only solution that they have. A two-state solution is not possible for Palestine. Ek to wajah aap ye le sakte hain ki two-state solution jo hai wo Palestine ke liye feasible kyun nahi hai, because they are going to be having an extremely strong neighbor as an antagonist, and we know what has happened with Kashmir as well. So this two-state solution is not feasible for Palestine at all as of right now, because they do not have any international voice and they do not have any international organization backing up their struggle. So since that is aside, uska hame background jo hai wo humne side pe kar diya hai. Israel is increasingly becoming embroiled again with Hezbollah, लास्ट वीक दे कंडक्टेड एन एयर स्ट्राइक इन सीरिया दैट किल्ड वन हिज़्बुल्ला फाइटर. दिस एयर स्ट्राइक वॉज इन कोलेबरेशन विद यूएस अथॉरिटीज इन कोलेबरेशन विद द यूएस मिलिट्री एज अ पार्ट ऑफ अ शेडो वॉर. सो they killed one Hezbollah fighter and Hezbollah released a statement that they would be conducting some kind of activity to punish Israel for what they had done. And as of right now, Israel claims that a number of rockets were fired into Lebanon, into the southern border between Lebanon and Israel. And Israel claims that a number of military fighters from Hezbollah were trying to infiltrate Israel from that side, from the southern border side. Whereas Lebanon says that this is a patently false flag operation and Lebanon somehow is being set up or Hezbollah somehow is being set up. इस सब की इस टाइम पे क्या जरूरत है? Israel is fast devolving from power. जो यूएस के साथ हुआ बिकॉज ऑफ द कोरोना वायरस पेंडेमिक दैट इज नाउ हैपनिंग विद इजराइल बिकॉज ऑफ द कोरोना वायरस पेंडेमिक. दे फास्ट यूजिंग क्रेडिबिलिटी बिटवीन देमसेल्व्स बिटवीन द स्टेट एंड द पीपल. सो सबसे आसान तरीकेकार क्या होता है? आप वॉर रेटोरिक को ले आए, ठीक है? मेक श्योर दैट द सिटीजन्स ऑफ पैलेस द सिटीजन्स ऑफ इजराइल फील थ्रेटन्ड फॉर देयर लाइव्स, ठीक है? सो दे वुड बी ट्राइंग टू ब्रिंग इन टू पावर अ गवर्नमेंट, ठीक है? पॉसिबली गिव बेंजामिन नेतन्याहू अनदर टर्म इन ऑफिस. एंड जो कंजर्वेटिव एलिमेंट्स हैं इसराइल के अंदर, वो जो है वो इस मंत्रा को क्यों पुश कर रहे हैं? बिकॉज इट इज ईजियर टू कंट्रोल द मैसेज व्हेन यू कैन ब्लेम समवन आउटसाइड, ठीक है? दिस इज व्हाट पॉपुलिस्ट लीडर्स डू एंड बेंजामिन नेतन्याहू इज अ पॉपुलिस्ट लीडर. सो ये बात भी हमने कर ली कि इसराइल किस तरह अपनी रेलेवेंस मेंटेन करना चाह रहा है इन दिस रीजन, ठीक है? नंबर टू, इसराइल इज ऑल्सो फेसिंग अ ह्यूज कोरोना वायरस पेंडेमिक आउटब्रेक एंड देयर रिस्पॉन्स इज बंगल. नंबर थ्री, इट इज फास्ट लूजिंग एनी क्रेडेंस इन द रीजन. नंबर फोर, इट इज नाउ ऑल्सो लूजिंग द पैलेस्टीनियन अथॉरिटी. सो द पैलेस्टीनियन अथॉरिटी वॉज टू एक्ट एज अ गो बिटवीन it was to act as a go between the Israeli people and the Palestinian and the Israeli authorities. So the PA is now fast becoming decimated. They have announced that they would not be issuing permits anymore. They have announced that they would not be taking any funds that they take from Israel as a part of the Oslo Convention. Israel has to pay for the upkeep of the PA. They are not taking any funds from the Israeli authorities. They have started shifting up their offices. They have started shifting up sensitive documents, and this might be an Israeli, you can say, an Israeli triumph, but it can also bode a lot of ill for Israel as well. The Palestinian Authority is seen as a cornerstone of Palestine's struggle for freedom, for self-expression, for determination, self-determination, I would say. So when the PA, because of pressure from the Israeli side, or because they feel that they do not have any kind of clout left with the people, their political agenda is not being met with much fervor from the people, so usko jo hai wo slowly and steadily jo hai wo they are now downsizing. That has left the Palestinian political scene in chaos. At the start of the pandemic, around 3 lakh Palestinian workers were issued permits from the Israeli side and also 2 months free stay along with food and shelter. Now, why did this happen? It happened because the political authorities from both sides, basically jo foreign ministers hain from the Palestine, basically jo aapke finance ministers hain from the Palestinian side and the Israeli side, they both worked together because they believed that political motivation would would create a path ahead. That did happen. Aapke paas Palestinians jo hain wo they went en masse into Israel. They are living there, they are working there. लेकिन अगर आपके पास पॉलिटिकल लीडरशिप पैलेस्टीन की साइड पे नहीं होगी तो इसराइल वुड हैव अ वेरी डिफिकल्ट टाइम ट्राइंग टू रीच आउट टुवर्ड्स द पीपल. तो एक बात तो ये है कि पीए फील्स अबैंडन्ड बिकॉज इसराइल ने समहाउ हैज एस्टैब्लिश्ड अ पीपल टू पीपल कॉन्टैक्ट Israeli authorities have established a people-to-people contact, and that removes the need for a go-between. But in the absence of a political body, Israel would have a more difficult time implementing its own decisions, its own agendas, or its own national interest upon the people of Palestine. So in conclusion, I would like to say that Israel as of right now is in a huge conundrum. It has been picking fights along the border with Hezbollah to make sure that it has some kind of political clout. The conservative leaders inside this region, inside Israel, are trying to make sure that they somehow stay relevant. Or relevancy ka sabse asaan tarika kar kya hai? Inside war. Aur sabse jo rivayati harif ek tarah ka Israel kar raha hai from day one has always been Hezbollah. The PA is slowly and steadily dissolving. The PA acts as a go-between between the people of Israel, between Palestinian authorities and the Israeli authorities. And in the absence of a political framework inside Palestine, it is going to be very difficult for the Israeli authorities to maintain any kind of their own national interest on the people of Israel, or to come to, or to have a negotiating body with which they can negotiate their own demands. Because we know that Palestine is in no shape to put forward demands of its own. And also, the one thing that I have missed is that they are also withdrawing any security activities that they used to conduct with Israeli military along the southern and northern sides of the border, especially in towns like Katana and Birez Iska. So, in jagahon pe aapke paas jo hai wo jab Palestinian authorities ya Palestinian ya PA maujood nahi hogi, to जो इसराइल का मंत्रा है ऑफ ट्राइंग टू ब्रिंग द पैलेस्टीनियन पीपल ऑन बोर्ड, एक ये भी बात है, ठीक है. हम लोग ये समझते हैं कि दे आर हेल्प बेंट ऑन एनेक्सिंग द रीजन, दे आर, लेकिन दे ऑल्सो हैव पुट फॉरवर्ड दिस मंत्रा दैट दे थिंक अबाउट द पीपल ऑफ पैलेस्टीन एज वेल, ठीक है. तो जब आपके पास PA नहीं है, ठीक है, तो पीपल टू पीपल कॉन्टेक्ट तो आपने कुछ हद तक इस्टेब्लिश कर लिया है, लेकिन इट विल नॉट स्टे लॉन्ग इफ देर इज नो political party or no political agenda to influence inside Palestine. So this is all for today. I hope this has been enlightening for you. And on a lighter note, aage aapke paas badi Eid aa rahi hai. I would like each and every one of you to stay home mercifully, whether through data skewing or whether through actual reduction in number of cases. The coronavirus pandemic in Pakistan is starting to ease down slowly and steadily. What we need to do is make sure that this curve stays flattened. So, in conclusion, I would like to wish all of you an advanced Eid Mubarak. Stay safe. Allah Hafiz.